Emma Schmidt with 13 off the bench. Tomlin, 11 off the bench. Caitlin Halfacre with 13 off the bench. Keep in mind that the Trojans don't have a bench right now. Two teams in vastly different positions that are both impressing in their own way tonight. Albert pulls up. No good. Didn't catch anything there. Albert was looking to splash home a momentum-changing triple. Good closeout by Sarah Martin. And timeout for TIU. This Trojan team showing a lot of positivity, continuing to encourage each other as the athletic training staff continuing to stretch out Gula. They've almost made it to the finish line. Just 3 minutes left in this one. TIU putting up a tremendous resistance here. The heart of a lion from every single player on this TIU team. Amber Reynolds, by the way, in the Trojan huddle right now, but she is on crutches and has got the shoe and sock off of that right foot. So that is not the news that anyone wanted to hear, especially the Trojan contingent. As the Trinity key players continue to drop, Reynolds was such a key presence, a great leader, one of the captains this year, along with Albert, and brought a key dynamic in terms of scoring to this Trojan team. She was among the lead scorers for much of the year. Provided big time contributions and spacing the floor, drilling long range shots, and no word on exactly what's going on with her, but we have to hope it'll be a short term absence. There is Martin, puts up the long range effort, no good, and Martin has missed each of her last two shots after starting 12 out of 14. Smith has a full head of steam but couldn't hang on to possession. This Trojan team right now, maybe not going through perfect sets on the offensive end, but they're saying, I'm going to go right at you, kick you in the teeth, and we're not going to back down for anything. As there goes Emma Schmidt with the tray. She's got a quiet 16 off the bench. IUNW just 3 points short of hitting 100. Albert to Gula. She's going to cue up another tray. Rims out. Black on the case. Puts it up. Smith, another effort. She's fouled. And a pair of offensive rebounds for the TIU Trojans. They trail by 45, but they play every minute like it's 0-0. And Jasmine Smith will go to the line to shoot two free throws. She has got 2 points tonight. And she nails the first one. The Trojans fired up as Smith adds to her point total. Key buckets and key confidence for the young freshman, Jasmine Smith. Looking to get her fourth, and she does. 2 out of 2 from the charity stripe. Martin on the baseline. They work it around the perimeter. Halfacre wanted another three-point attempt. Now Martin looking to get her 30-piece. Instead kicks out to Tomlin. The bank not friendly there. And Kieskowski has got the rebound. Albert taking her time with it. Over to Smith, good hands from Halfacre, but Kieskowski on the case had it poked free at the last possible moment. Now Martin looking to go all the way, another bucket as she breaks her mini slump of two consecutive misses. With the lay-in there, she's got 29 as a chance to reach that elusive 30-point threshold. Albert to Hattie Black. It's been the Hattie Black show of late as she draws the contact again. A masterful evening from Hattie Black. She is just Got no fear. Fired up 18 shots for the Trojans. Made it to the line an additional three times. She is just brings a gritty and determined nature to the Trojans each and every night, and I think this team feeds off her energy. Just a fearless player, a fearless scorer for TIU, and she's been outstanding on both ends of the floor. She hits the second free throw, 12 points and 12 boards for Hattie. Halfacre, Gula got a hand to it. Halfacre back in there. Albert doing jumping jacks, denying the pass. Now Martin looking to crack the 30-point threshold, scoops it up, no good. She tries to get her own, does. One more try, and she's hacked by Braylee Gula. So Sarah Martin continuing to add to a terrific outing, 29 points on 13 out of 17. 6 rebounds and 7 dimes for the senior guard from Crown Point, Indiana. And she nails the free throw. It's a 30-piece from Sarah Martin. And you've got to give her teammates a lot of credit for making that happen. Some great feeds to set her up all evening long. Whenever she broke to the basket, the ball would be there. And especially with the star Michaela Best only playing so many minutes tonight, it was point guard by committee. Great feeds all over the place. Now Albert off the heel. Albert stumbling for the board. Smith laying out. Three bodies hit the floor. And Wiry will pull it out. And the Red Hawks will try to run out the clock, but Smith is still chasing her. Boy, the Trojans just playing to the final whistle. Smiles on the faces of both players, Smith and Wiry, as they've got a ton of respect for each other. Smith jawing now, continuing to hop up and down. Great persistence from the freshman there. And that encapsulates this evening for the Trojans. As shorthanded as they were, it was so difficult for them to try to stay in it with this high-powered Red Hawk squad, but these teams have got a mutual respect for each other right now because they fought until the end in this thing. The Trojans will get a little bit of much-needed rest for a couple of days before they face the Red Hawks Indiana University counterpart, the Titans of Indiana University South Bend. A landmark evening for the Red Hawks as they get their 20th win of the campaign. Sarah Martin leading the way with 31 points. Michaela Best had 13. Caitlin Halfacre, 13. Abby Tomlin with 12. And Emma Schmidt with 16. Great and diverse offensive effort. But what about those Trojans? You had Kaya Albert posting a 13-point effort. Hattie Black, a double-double, 12 points and 12 rebounds. And Braylee Gula with 13 points, including splashing home a triple as she battled through those cramps to continue to deliver excellence. And that's what Coach PA preaches all evening long and all season long. Excellence, effort, and positivity. And there is just a galvanizing nature to this team right now. They are a unit, and they gave it everything they had. And Coach PA has got a lot to be proud of as she shares an embrace with Braylee Gula, who played her heart out tonight. What an evening for these Trojans. Unbelievable perseverance, and they truly have earned the moniker of Trojan Warriors tonight. Well, don't forget, folks, the Trojan men will be in action shortly. Tip-off for that ball game at 7:30, so be sure to join us momentarily. This is Ethan Oskroba signing off, but not for long. The Trojan women putting up a tremendous battle as they fall to the Red Hawks. Be sure to join us momentarily as the Trojan men go to work.
step out onto the court and use the talents and abilities that you've given us for your glory. We ask you to watch over us this evening as our athletes compete and keep them safe from all harm. In your name we pray. Now, fans, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First, we're going to visit the Red Hawks. At guard, a 5'10 senior from Chicago, Illinois, number 2, Malik Miller. At center, a 6'8 senior from Hopkins Park, Illinois, number 11, Marius Willard. At guard, a 6'2 junior from Lake Station, Indiana, number 20, Ryan forward, a 6'5 senior from Chicago Heights, Illinois, number 23, Jared Johnson. And at forward, a 6'5 junior from Chicago, number 25, Isaac Stendak. The Red Hawks are led by assistant coaches Devin Ellis, Steve Patchett, Eric Roman, and Alec Constantaris with head coach Javier Pereira. And now, the starting lineup for your T.I.U. Dragons! At guard, a 6-foot sophomore from Bowling Green, Illinois, number 2, Keenan Thomas! At guard, a 6'3 junior from Oswego, Illinois, number 22, Jack Calhoun! At forward, a 6'3 senior from Wayne.
All right, folks, well, as promised, we are back in action. The TIU Trojan men going up against the Indiana University Red Hawks here at Van Dixhorn Arena. You know the story with this Trojan team. They like to play fast, they play with a ton of energy, and they have played well this season. They're 13-10, as here's the bank shot jumper by Lamarius Lillard, the 6'8 center, showing off some of his versatility there. But Trinity loves to get out and run in transition. They have several great athletes and like to use them to great effect. Here's Jack Calhoun, the sniper, with his first field goal attempt of the night. And that comes up short. Bowled out of the mess by Lillard. Now it's Ryan LaFollette probing, and the three-pointer by Isaac Stanback. It's no good. Board corralled by the Trojan star, Diamond Presniakovas. Brandon Lawani thought about a three. He jump stops to the inside and gets Trinity on the board. The Red Hawks having a solid season as well. They're 11-13. On the year, looking to inch a game back toward 500 as the Trojans look to continue to separate themselves from the 500 mark. LaFollette is pursued by Thomas. A double team comes, but he'll flip it back out to Jared Johnson. Johnson, long range bomb, no good. Great rebound by Lillard, but it's poked free. Xavier Cooper comes away with it. Flips it all the way down court. But a little bit out of sync with Calhoun. Here is Malik Miller. He will run the point for the Red Hawks. Miscommunication with Johnson there. But good ball movement gets Lillard free for the little push shot. And he puts it home. Xavier Cooper will take the ball down the floor for Trinity. He and Keontae Thomas are a couple of the primary ball handlers. There's Thomas feeling some confidence. Throws up a three. It's no good. Presniakovas almost had the steal, but instead it's Miller exploding to the cup. And a hot start for IUNW. The Trojans looking to bounce back after a 20-point loss against Roosevelt. Last time out, there's Lawani getting the bucket. And Trinity looking to rekindle some momentum after their offense was stymied in that contest, held to just 53 points. Uncharacteristic for this high firepower Trojan team. Active hands to force the turnover now as Cahoon comes away with it, turns on the afterburners, but Miller stonewalls him. A foul is called against Miller, so a good break for the Trojans, who will hang on to it. Trinity is in their home grays, the Red Hawks, wearing black with those red accents. It is Keontae Thomas, Jack Cahoon, Diamond Presniakovas, Brandon Lawani, and Xavier Cooper, the five out there for Greg Miller. And Javier Heredia, the head coach of IUNW. As there goes Presniakovas on a nice cut and a good feed. The Trojans' leading scorer gets his first bucket tonight. But for the Red Hawks, it's Malik Miller, Lamarius Lillard, Ryan LaFollette, Jared Johnson, and Isaac Stanback. Here's Miller, shoves it inside. And Johnson suspends in the air and gets the finish. Cooper turns on the Jets. He's swatted from behind by Stanback. That thing bounced off the backboard and actually created momentum for La Follette. But the Trojans return the favor. Great pursuit defensively by TIU. They got bodies back and were able to repel the counterattack from La Follette. Lillard, listed as a center, and he's got great height, but he can play all around as he goes up here and draws the contact. A lot of height out there, period, for this Red Hawk team, as you've got three players, 6'5 or above. Lillard listed at 6'8, though. Looking at him alongside his teammates, that might be a bit of an aggressive figure, but still very tall, as is Jared Johnson and Isaac Stanback, both of those two standing at 6'5". So great height and great length that make this Red Hawk team a force to be reckoned with. And you've got La Follette at 6'2", and Malik Miller at 5'10", as the second attempt from Lillard is no good. Lawani works it back out to Thomas. Was looking to get the elbow jumper, but he couldn't get the release. Now the windshield wiper. A Jordan-esque finish from Brandon Lawani. Got his man going the wrong way to shuffle free. Hit the shimmy and the finish. Now out of sync are the Red Hawks. La Follette hit the cut at exactly the wrong moment. A look of exasperation on the face of Jared Johnson as he picks up the turnover. The Trojans, after a slow start, have trimmed the four-point deficit to just one, looking to take their first lead of the evening. Presniakovas lofts it up for Lawani. Lawani is all knees and elbows, but he delivers a pinpoint feed. Keontae Thomas finishing through the contact. The flexible release from Thomas as he was suspended in the elements and found a way to force that one up and through. Terrific finish from Thomas, who spent much of the season as the Trojans' lead scorer. He converts the three-point play. But Thomas leads this team in assists, second on the team in scoring, leads them in steals as well. A force on both ends for Trinity. There's a great cut from Jarrah Johnson. And the big man connection as Stanback feeds him up. You got big guys that can dole out dimes like that. It's tough to stop. Now here's Miller off the turnover as he trots his way through and has something to say to Thomas, and he gets teed up. Thomas has got a smile on his face there as Miller, showing a bit of a lack of discipline, had to rub it in to Keontae Thomas, and he'll cost his team perhaps a couple of points if the talented sophomore Thomas can put these free throws home. The Red Hawks staff not happy with that, as first free throw is no good, but Miller might have shuffled with it. It looked like he took a few too many steps as he trotted his way toward the bucket. A great finish nonetheless, but he had to have a little something to say, and that'll cost his team a singular tally there as Keontae Thomas drills the second free throw. Thomas, a 68% shooter from the line. So it's an aspect of his game you'd like to see him continue to work on. This Trojan team as a whole wants to get better at free throw shooting. He's got one out of two there. Now here is Presnikovas off the pirouette. It's no good. Stanback comfortably taking it up the floor despite his burly 6'5 frame. Now here is Keanu Lane putting it up, and crashing to the rack was Johnson. Looked like he finished through some contact. No call, but no call necessary. Impressive finish for him. Now Thomas, mid-range, no good. And Jack Cahoon took a spill, and he is down and writhing in pain, and he's clutching at his forehead, and that is not what you want to see. Such a key player for the Trojans, and he seems to be in some pain here. Got tangled up in the post while contesting for the board. And he is still face down as he converses with the training staff. But Jack Cahoon, such a key player for this Trojan team, as he's able to get to his feet, but noticeably disoriented. That is unfortunate. Hopefully, he'll be cleared to return soon. But Cahoon, a noted sniper from the outside, a decisive cutter. He's got great scoring instincts and has really become a fixture in the Trojans' starting lineup, and he will head to the sideline. Boy, it's been a really unfortunate night with injuries out here. Otherwise, really enjoyable basketball has been marred by several players going down. Here's Tyler Houston. He turns on the burners, becomes up short. Monte Lambert has the board, flips it out quickly for Thomas, and it's off on Thomas. It is as an unlucky break. It hit his head as it was swatted out of bounds. But we saw in the women's game, saw Amber Reynolds suffer an injury. She was on crutches after that. We saw Carly Miller of the Red Hawks suffer an ankle injury as well. She was able to walk it off somewhat, but she did not return to the proceedings. Now Jack Cahoon taking a hard blow to the head. So not what you want to see out here. It's a part of the sport as Stanback hits the mid-range J to put the Red Hawks up by five, but it is something that absolutely nobody likes, no matter who you root for. Lawani flicks it out for Lambert. Lambert, the New York native. Terrific scorer, terrific athlete. Always brings life on the offensive end. Now Lawani gets tangled up, and it's a jump ball. Nice work from the Red Hawks there, forcing the issue, as if you give Lawani time and space to operate in the post, he'll make you pay every time. Here's Cooper off the inbound feed, no good. Strong rebound, clapped down by Johnson. Johnson hits the little stop and go and flips it out to no one in particular. Thomas almost had a brilliant dribble move, but couldn't hang on as he got caught between a dribble and a pass down the court to Xavier Cooper, who was breaking free. So the rival squads trade turnovers. And now a push off against Tyler Houston. Keontae Thomas clapping it up. There was a little bit of an extension of the arm by Houston, but I definitely think Thomas sold that one a little bit. A cagey play from the second year man. Lawani will head to the bench for a break, as Asher Bloom will check in for the first time. Really talented backup center for the Trojans, plays second fiddle to Lawani, but he brings a lot of ability to this offense and defense. Presnikovas went up, but he lost it. Houston flips it out. Good ball movement. Three-pointer for Lillard. And he puts it home. Lamarius Lillard making it rain from the outside, and an ambush from the Red Hawks. They lead by eight. Now Lambert picks his way inside, throws it up off the cylinder. No good. Red Hawks could have a two-on-one. Here's the lob, and it's finished off by Lillard, perfectly in sync with the Johnson feed. And this has been impressive stuff from the Red Hawks as the Trojans call timeout. Already a 10-point lead for the visitor. Boy, you look at their record. Nothing really jumped out about this team, but I really like their approach. They're playing almost positionless basketball. They've got bigs that are athletic enough to run the point, and they've got guards that are sizable enough to play in the post, and they just like to come at you quickly. Whoever's got the ball, get in the best position for him to do something with it. They're not too worried about what personnel is deployed or where. They are simply going to come at you. It's almost a street ball type of vibe, and this is the future of basketball, going away from defined positions to optimize the game. It's almost the basketball counterpart of the total football concept that you think about in soccer, pioneered by some of the greats like Alfredo Di Stefano and Johan Cruyff with their respective squads. And you gain such an advantage when you've got the personnel where you can put a variety of people in a variety of different spots. And that's the way that the Red Hawks are coming at the Trojans so far today. Here's Presnikovas. Leads the team in scoring this year. They could use a couple buckets right now. Thomas flips it out to the do-it-all guard Cooper. Cooper to the inside, and Bloom couldn't slingshot it down as he waved at it. The Redhawks smelling blood in the early going here. 12 minutes remaining in the opening half. Pass inside and now out, but it was sprayed away errantly by Keone Lane. Keontae Thomas, the Trojans' leading assist man. He's had an outstanding sophomore season. Gives it up for Bloom. Trying to bang bodies in the post. Little give and go. Bloom is soaring to the rack. And he gets hacked. So Bloom with a decisive drive. Just making it happen. And creates the opportunity. For the Trojans, foul is on the floor. And now here is Colby Cross into the ballgame. He missed significant time with an injury. He is a key man for the Trojans. A great long-range shooter as we see number 10 get some action. Thomas flips it over to Bloom, in and out of his hands. Davion Washington thought about stepping into a triple. Instead, he works it back out to the perimeter. Lambert nearly picked it off. Instead, it's Lane money. And the lead is up to a high watermark of 13. This is the same score we saw in the women's game, 25-12 in favor of the visitors. A suboptimal start. Now Cooper hoists it up. It's no good. Bloom looking for reinforcements. Has it knocked away. Here goes Lane to the outside. Stop and go, and triple is snapped through by Jared Johnson. What a start for the visiting side. 28-12. The Trojans have been punched in the mouth to start things off here on a Wednesday night in Van Dixhorn. My goodness. Well, you talk about how good it is for the Trojans to have Colby Cross back, as he missed significant time with an injury, did not play at all in the month of December or January. As they continue to work his minutes up, he's a significant presence off the bench for TIU, the team leader in free throw percentage, shooting 83%, and he is also second in three-point percentage on the team, shooting 44% from beyond the arc. Lawani is stifled here, and oh boy, Lane almost flew up for the jam, but his hubris, perhaps his weakness on that occasion, didn't quite have the ups for the standstill dunk. Lawani does, however, as that one settles through. So a big-time bucket at a big time for the Trojans. Houston running the point as the Red Hawk staff was disgusted with the foul, the technical against Miller, and perhaps teaching him a lesson here. Three-pointer in and out. Washington soars for the rebound to the inside. Rim run by Lillard, and he puts it home. Plus the contact. Boy, everything is clicking for the Red Hawks right now. Lillard looking to complete a three-point play and keep all that momentum on the Red Hawks side. They are more than doubling up the Trojans' tally. What do Greg Miller's boys have for an answer? Here's Cooper to Lawani, and now Thomas going to work with it. Out to Cross. Lawani finds the open man Lambert. He leads the team in long-range shooting. Lambert fires it in to Lawani, back for Thomas. Thomas stonewalled by Houston. Tough shot, but he gets it to go. Boy, a terrific fall away look by Keontae Thomas. Shades of the great Kobe Bryant on a look like that. A three-pointer for Washington. Boy, everything's been going down for the Red Hawks, but not this one. Nice cut by Lambert. Acrobatic finish, but it won't go down. A quality feed by Thomas. And Lambert tried to make that mid-air adjustment, but couldn't quite get the reverse layup to go. Lane with the three over the backboard. So Trinity, a team that's short a couple men. Nothing like what we saw with the Trojan women's team, but Jaden Thomas and Stratton Lovorn, a couple of terrific young players for the Trojans, out with injuries tonight. Here's Cross with the three, no good. And Miller back in the game, lobs this one up for the gliding Johnson, who puts it home. Well, one way or another, the personnel the Trojans have out there, certainly strong, and you would hope that they would get right in a matter of moments here. No good on the three from Lawani. Rebound wrestled loose by Standback. Standback hits the stop and go. Pops out to Johnson. Now Standback on the wing. Jackhammering his way inside. Looking for something. Falling away. And he gets the shooter's bounce. Timeout is called. And this is getting a little bit ugly in a game that felt very winnable for the Trojans. They have dug themselves a significant deficit, trailing by a 35-16 margin. a concerning start for this Trojan team. Well, the Trinity offense has been fairly stagnant, but the bigger problem has been the defensive effort so far, as they are surrendering a 63% rate from the floor to IUNW. A lot of that you've just got a hand to the Red Hawks. They've been terrific here early. But the Trojans, this team has struggled a little bit defensively all season long. It's been their Achilles heel. They've got an offense that could have them right at the top of the conference, and they're just trying to continue to shore things up on the defensive end. Tonight has been a setback in that regard. But credit the Red Hawks. They have taken it right to the Trojans, shooting 63% from the floor. Also, a quick housekeeping note. Jack Cahoon is in the huddle with his Trojan teammates after sustaining that shot earlier in the period, where his head hit the ground pretty hard. He's got some ice on the forehead right now. It doesn't seem like he'll be returning, especially given the tricky nature of head injuries. But it's good to see that he's functioning fairly normally and seems like he's going to be all right. Hopefully a short absence for him. Teardrop is good for Presniakovas off the Lawani feed. Now Johnson for Malik Miller. Malik Miller, great body control as he floated toward the rack and put that one through. Thomas into Cross. Back to Thomas, looking for Cross, but he was cutting. Great instincts by Cooper to hang on to it. He says, I'll take that. Puts up the shot, but too strong. Board snared by Lillard. Miller around the screen, and now Thomas is down, grabbing at his shoulder, and finally the officials blow the whistle. He was rolling in agony for a couple of seconds there before they stopped it, and Thomas seems to be in a lot of pain, and my goodness, this unfortunate run just continues. The fourth player we've seen fighting some sort of an injury tonight, and the third Trojan in these two games, the women's and the men's. And we saw Thomas perhaps slightly injure his shoulder a couple of games ago, and you wonder if this is a continuation of that, as he's definitely got that characteristic angled walk and is clutching at that left shoulder, I believe it is. Oh boy, just tough scenes here at Van Dixhorn. He's in some pain. Good to see him able to get up and try and stretch it out a little bit as he talks with the Trojan training staff that has been busy tonight. Just the dark side of athletics in general. And Thomas, who's in the midst of a terrific campaign for the Trojans, sidelined here. He'll head back to the bench for the moment. Three-pointer in and out as Lawani snags the board. Here goes Cooper to the inside, and a foul against Lawani on the entry pass. Or rather, a foul committed on Lawani, as Miller will check back out. He's picked up his third foul already. Obviously that technical not helping his cause. Lawani misses the first free throw as Tyler Houston will check back in for Miller, who we may not see again for this first half, sitting on the trio of personals. Lawani makes good on the second free throw. Well, checking in for the Trojans, it is Braden Betzner, the freshman guard, getting some big minutes here as Cooper forces the turnover. But Betzner, number three for the Trojans, will need to step up in the absence of Thomas. This one plinkoing about, but it gets ahead of the pack, and great teamwork as Lillard finishes on the handoff by Javion Reed. Now, Cooper changing speeds, works it out to Betzner, who slips it over to Lawani. Lawani got straightened up. Betzner for three. No good. foul under the cup will go against the home side. So the Trojans trying to stave off a Red Hawk strike. It is 39-19 in favor of the visitors, a 20-point gap separating these two. Here's Lillard on the baseline. Good ball movement as they continue to ping it around. Running down the shot clock are the Red Hawks. To the outside, three-pointer Johnson, money. And it's just automatic for the Red Hawks right now. It's their fourth three-pointer of the contest. Presniakovas looking to go get a bucket. Great tip in by Lawani. That's a big part of his game. We've seen it all season long. He will crash to the rim, use his athleticism and those veteran instincts to get to the cup. Now a deep three from Johnson. No good. Here's Cross. He'll take his time with it. As with Thomas out, it'll be point guard by committee for this team. And we'll scratch that. Thomas back in the game now, surprisingly. I hadn't picked up on that detail, but he'll fire away a three, and he says hello. No, I see you out there, Keontae Thomas, a three-pointer from the man who was injured moments ago. So that is great news for TIU, that he's not only back in, but contributing in a big way. Houston out for Johnson. Johnson picking his way through the rubble. Now stand back. Long range on the midi. He's got it. That is a long two for Standback. And now this pass projected ahead of the field. An errant throw by Keontae Thomas. So the 20-point Trojan deficit holding firm here. But boy, it is great to see Keontae Thomas back out there. This Trinity program cannot afford to lose another soldier tonight. Here we saw the Trojan women's game. We saw them lose Amber Reynolds, lose Audrey Peck to foul trouble. As here's the mid-range shot, no good from Standback. Rebound for Betzner. And then we see Jack Cahoon suffering the head injury. And it's just good to see that it's nothing serious in the case of a key cog in the Trojan wheel, Keontae Thomas. Last touch by Presniakovas in the baseline skirmish. So IUNW will go to work. It is Tyler Houston who's got an extended minutes at the point guard spot, and he rolls in his first bucket of the day. Using his length to create that opportunity and finish the gliding layup. Now Thomas, baseline fine, and that is Jack Cahoon. Oh boy, the Trojan unit is whole again. And I'm surprised to see that. Jack Cahoon back in the ball game here. Given the tricky nature of head injuries, evidently he's been cleared to return. Lamarius Lillard was looking to catch a body there. But he's prevented by virtue of a foul. Well, in a matter of moments, we get both Keontae Thomas and Jack Cahoon returning to the contest, and that is a phenomenal sign for this Trojan team. A couple of key contributors there. Back in action for the blue and white. First free throw, no good from Lillard. As Lawani will head to the bench, we'll see the first action of the night for Nabil Kone, the Mali native. In his second year as a Trojan, he'll grab the rebound immediately. Off the second free throw miss. 0 for 2 from the line is Lillard. And here come the Trojans to the inside. Good feed. And the body contact will send Thomas to the stripe. So Thomas playing with no fear, leading with that left shoulder and going right into the contact. Seems like that might just be an issue that flares up on him from time to time, but it's his non-shooting arm, and he's certainly committed to playing through it. Some toughness out here from the second-year man from Bolingbrook, Illinois, Keontae Thomas. As he puts the second free throw home, 68% from the line. And he is 3 out of 4 tonight. Toward the inside, boy. That one bounced off the head of Thomas, and a fortunate carom that it came back to Standback, who takes advantage with the nifty lay-in. Now Presniakovas. Quiet night for him. He's got just 4. Kone going to work on the inside. Lost the handle. Good defensive work by Standback. More substitutes for the Redhawks as Houston will head to the bench. We'll see some work for perhaps the third string point guard, Trey Steinhilber, taking advantage of the foul trouble that both Houston and Miller are in. There's 2 fouls against Houston and 3 against Miller, so both those key players need to be around at the end for the Redhawks, or at least one of them, so smart move by the coaching staff as they bring in reinforcements. The turnaround effort is short from Standback. Now Presniakovas to Kone, who blasts off for the easy lay-in. Nabil Kone getting on the board. Just the 5th Trojan to score. And what has not been a terrific effort from the Trojans offensively. Here's a nice bit of work by Thomas, turns on the Jets. Oh, what a terrific bucket, but they're going to say an offensive foul. Oh, man, I'm not so sure about that one. It did not look like the defender was established, and he might have been the restricted area anyway. But they're going to call it an offensive foul, negating an outstanding bucket from Thomas. But to conclude my earlier point, the Trojans haven't been bad offensively, but they're going to need to turn it up if the Redhawks are going to manage to maintain this type of performance on the offensive end. This is a Trojan team that prides themselves on their scoring. They're going to need a little bit more of it. They're clamping down defensively, however. There's Kone with the athletic block as he was coming down, managed not to foul. Now a great feed, Thomas to Cahoon, and a couple of players that we thought might be missing some time, and they're back out on the floor and contributing in a big way, cutting into this deficit. Under a minute remaining, half number one. Johnson running down the clock, perhaps trying to manipulate the timepiece and make sure his team gets the last shot on offense. That's a nice feed, though, as Javion Reed will crack the scoring column. Well, if that was the plan for the Redhawks, it's backfired here as the Trojans will have the last offensive look. Keontae Thomas will work against Reed, several feet from the bucket, putting on some moves. Triple is up and off the front rim by Presniakovas. Last second effort perhaps, as Steinhilber tried to get a shot free. He does not. The Trojans clamping down defensively at the end, and they started to get their offensive motor going, but nonetheless they trail 50-31. Really strong offensive period for the visitors. They came into this building and applied the pressure right from the get-go, same as the Trojan women did, or rather the Red Hawk women did against the Trojans in the earlier contest. And we'll be back very shortly with more action here from Van Dixhorn. The Trojans trail by 19 after a half. Well, hello, folks, and welcome back inside Van Dixhorn as we get you set for the second half of what has been an exciting salvo between the TIU Trojans and the Indiana University Red Hawks. This ball game has got major implications in the thick of the CCAC standings. These two teams right next to each other in those standings. Indiana University Northwest 10-6 in the conference, and that's good enough for sixth place. The Trojans at 8-7 there in seventh. So these are big games as you're playing for postseason positioning and obviously the right to play in the CCAC postseason. So a major contest here. And so far, it's been the Red Hawks that have gotten the better of Trinity. A team that, aforementioned, 10-6 in conference. They struggled with their overall record. They're 11-13, but don't let that fool you. They've played some outstanding non-conference competition that has led to that 1-7 non-conference mark, and they are coming out firing today. They're proving it. They're shooting 61% from the floor en route to a 50-point barrage that has the Trojans playing from behind. Trinity navigated through a minefield of difficulties, including losing both Jack Cahoon briefly to a potential head injury evaluation and losing their star guard Keontae Thomas to an apparent left shoulder injury. Both men have been cleared to return, and that's great news for the Trojan faithful. But they've got a long ways to go. They're going to need both those guys and really everybody on the roster if they're going to find a way to vaporize this 19-point downturn and emerge victorious in this pivotal CCAC matchup tonight. A nice moment at halftime moments ago as the Trojan women's volleyball team, which in December capped off a 30-9 campaign by winning the NCCAA national title. They got their banner mounted next to the Trojan scoreboard. The whole team was there along with head coach Luke Ward, assistant coach Kennedy Mang, and especially with so many great veteran players in their final year on that team. Stars like Brianna Torres, Anna Skripshak, Lana Vujosevic, all on the backside of their careers. Jalen Freeman, fifth-year player, the great libero for the Trojans, Emma Gallegos. I mean, so many great players, and that's just to name a few that are on their way out as Trojan players. And you could not picture a better send-off than winning the national title. And athletics up and down all the time. You see a team like the Trojan men's volleyball or women's basketball teams that are building that foundation. It's so cool to see what the end of the road looks like, what that final destination looks like. And this Trojan women's volleyball team really made believers in all of us this past fall. It was one heck of a season for them. Now back to business. The Red Hawks with possession here as there's a bump on the perimeter. Going to be called against Cooper. Some 40 feet from the bucket. Not a great foul against Cooper, but there also didn't appear to be a whole lot of contact. Inbound lobbed into Malik Miller, who's playing with three personal fouls. Now Ryan LaFollette had his pocket picked. We saw a little bit of Ryan early on as he started the game, but not much since. Now Thomas free to fire, gets the bounce off the rim twice. And my goodness, that was shades of the series clinching bucket a couple years ago by Kawhi Leonard in game 7 against the Sixers, except the opposite result. It would not go down. Now Thomas nearly had a steal, but he had stepped on the boundary. And possession sticks with the Red Hawks of IUNW. Miller looking for options. Scans and gets it out to Johnson. Lamarius Lillard inside to Johnson, who mistimed his leap. to try to get the subsequent board. 2-on-1, Cahoon with the layup on the Cooper feed. The versatility of Xavier Cooper, he really can do it all. Among the team leaders in a variety of categories, he leads in rebounding and is second in assists. A really unique combo for the extremely muscular and physical guard. Now battling for it under the bucket, and it'll go the way of Trinity. So TIU bringing some good momentum here into the second half as they look to reignite their offense. And there's Cooper just plunging toward the bucket. Takes the contact and gets the finish. Cooper 100% the aggressor there. And finding a way to give his team a timely bucket. Johnson pulls up from long range off the mark. He missed it left. Now here's Cooper, the hot hand, going in there again. It'll stay with Trinity. Boy, there's nothing scarier than when a player starts to feel himself a little bit and it just takes it right to the rack with authority. That's what we're seeing from Xavier Cooper. The Redhawks, I'm sure, thrilled to get the Trojans in the half-court set. Now here's Presniakovas. Shovels it over to Thomas for Lawani. He mishandled it, got it back. Three-pointer, no good. Cahoon almost had the tip, but Miller is on it. Miller to Johnson. Oh my goodness. A terrific over-the-shoulder layup by Johnson. He's now got himself 16 points. An impressive effort from Johnson as he's now the lead scorer, a point ahead of Lamarius Lillard. Cooper free to fire. No good. Thomas times his jump properly. It's blocked, but back to Lawani. The fifth-year man Lawani showcasing his veteran presence in the right place at the right time to collect the easy two. Stand back. Another one of these versatile guard slash forward type. Can do a little bit of everything. It's knocked loose. Here's Presniakovas over to Cahoon. Cooper has got it and puts it back up, but a foul, a loose ball foul, will put the ball in the hands of the Redhawks. A tough call there. That was almost a terrific finish from Cahoon, and Cooper seemed like he might have an and-one bucket. Instead, the Trojans give possession away. Cooper will take a rest here as he had been flying down court on a series of possessions, so a well-deserved breather for him, as we'll see Monte Lambert. To the inside. Oh, baby. Stand back went for the highlight, but he lost the handle. He was wide open. And trying to get a little too showy with it. And there's old, reliable Brandon Lawani. And the deficit's cut down to 13. The Trojans are back in this thing. Malik Miller signaling for a timeout, jawing at his teammates. They're out of sync. And the Trojans taking advantage of it. TIU is right back in it. Well, the Trojan offense in the first half was so-so. They weren't overly impressive, and this is a Trojan team that prides themselves on their offense. But the condition was, if their offense is not going to be up to snuff, they're going to have to step it up defensively, and that's exactly what they've done here in this second half, only surrendering 2 points to their rivals through the first 3.5 minutes. They have trimmed the deficit down to 13 points, and the hometown Trojans have to be feeling a lot better about themselves and their prospects of victory right now than they did just about 5 minutes ago at the start of this second half. Trojan unit sprinting out there. Coach Miller deploying Lambert, Lawani, Presniakovas, Keontae Thomas, and Jack Cahoon. Cahoon got burned on the cut there, though. Great move by Johnson, and it was in sync. A tough look to battle off there. And well-coordinated offense from the Redhawks. Now here's Lawani, had it knocked free. Second effort is good. Brandon Lawani finding a way to put it home for the Trojans. Here's Johnson. Not a lot of 6'5 forwards that are going to run the point, but that's the luxury that this team has. Miller rejects the screen. High steps through the defense. Out to Johnson. Got his man in the air. Flails it up. No good. And Presniakovas was pursuing the rebound but couldn't hang on. Trojans battling back early second half. Miller looking for somebody. A down swipe by Cahoon. Nearly had the steal. Now the elbow J for Lillard. No good. Presniakovas with a head of steam. Got options on the wings. Instead he goes right into his man. Offensive foul. And Lillard was tiptoeing the restricted area, but he was not quite in it, and he managed to get set. Took the shoulder from Presniakovas, who barreled in hard. Trojans are going to need more from their lead scorer, Presniakovas. He's only taking 4 shots from the field and has just 4 points. It's been a quiet evening for Cooper with just 2 points, Presniakovas with 4, and Cahoon with 6. Trojans have got great contributions from Keontae Thomas and Brandon Lawani, but their second unit really not contributing a whole lot so far, and they have several great scorers on this team. They'll need to get them going, will the Trojans, if they want to win tonight. 3-point effort, no good, stand back. So that one was well off the mark from Isaac Standback. He's had a solid evening so far. He's got 8 points for the Red Hawks, one of their solid complementary players. Thomas over to Cahoon. Cahoon against La Follette. Has it knocked loose. A whirl from Miller. Got it into the hands of his teammate Lillard, but now it's stolen by the Trojans. Here comes Monte Lambert. Lambert with the cross inside. Good feed by Thomas. And maybe that'll get the diamond going. Timeout by IUNW. The lead is down to 11. As Trinity continues to ratchet up the intensity. And they have got plenty of time to further close in on their conference rival. But this is exactly what you want to see in the second half from the Trojans. They've allowed just 4 points, and they have come on storming out offensively and are on the verge of reducing the Red Hawk advantage to single digits. Both these teams have had a couple of players having a terrific night. Jared Johnson with 18. He's been all over the place for the Red Hawks. And Lamarius Lillard has 15 of his own for the IUNW squad. The Trojans have 10 from Keontae Thomas and 17 from Brandon Lawani. It feels like whoever is going to get their supporting cast going is going to have a great chance to win tonight. 3-pointer La Follette, and that is money right on cue. Ryan La Follette gets his first basket of the evening. A 3-point banger from La Follette. Lawani looking to answer. Cups it out toward Lambert. Lambert fall away off one leg. Did his best Dirk impression, but couldn't get it to drop down. Miller hits the accelerator. Flings it over the shoulder to La Follette. It is Johnson firing again. No good this time. Unable to break the 20-point threshold with that one. Now Lawani on the block. Dimes up Presniakovas. But Johnson skies for the stuff. And he subsequently throws it away, turning a great play into a non-entity there. Davion Washington back in as Standback will get a rest for the Red Hawks. Extended run here for Monte Lambert as the Trojans look to keep their offense humming. Inbound coming up for TIU. Tyler Houston checking back in for Malik Miller, who's still playing with those three fouls. Houston has two of his own. Oh, good find, but Cahoon couldn't get the finish on the reverse lay. Left it a tad short. Now Johnson. Redhawks riding through their top man. La Follette. Errant pass. Good pursuit by Thomas. But one of the Trojans did get a fingertip to it. Johnson the inbound. Here's Houston. He did a nice job running the offense. Though he's not made a huge offensive contribution. La Follette is stifled on the inside. Mid-range J is good. And it's the sweet stroke of Lamarius Lillard. Lillard with 17. Johnson with 18. Those two combining for more than half of their team's points. Now Lawani floating toward the cylinder. No good. Rebound Presniakovas. Kicks it to the corner. Thomas hit the ground running, but the feed was a little bit off. Wrestled free by Lawani, and no good. There's a lid on the bucket for the Trojans this possession as they persevere but cannot get the finish. Now Presniakovas contesting the pass and wriggling free with it. He is slapped, and it'll stay the way of TIU. Boy, that was a loud sound. I could hear that with the headphones on up here. But I guess it was all ball, at least, in the eyes of the officials, and Presniakovas not lodging a complaint. Diamond's got it. He slings it out for Lambert. Lambert lowers the shoulder and gets the contact. Good work from Monte Lambert as he will earn himself a trip to the stripe. Quiet evening for Lambert. He is 0-for-4 from the field so far, but a key player for the Trojans off the bench, shooting a mind-numbing 54% from three-point land this year. He has been a key man for the Trojans off the bench. He gets hot in a hurry. He plays with an attitude. He comes right at you. He is really fun to watch. As Lawani will check out in favor of Nabil Kone as we continue to see the three-headed post monster of the Trojans with Lawani backed up by Asher Bloom and Abel Kone. Houston taking it up the floor. It's going nowhere. Flips it out to La Follette, who worked his way free off the screen. Rebound off the head of Tyler Houston, who tried to keep it on that side but is unsuccessful in that pursuit. Trojan basketball. They're looking to continue to whittle down the 14-point Red Hawk lead. Thomas leaves it for Cooper. Lambert to Thomas. Thomas going to the cylinder, and he gets the contact. Well, you have to love the determination and drive of Keontae Thomas. You got a player like him who shoots really well, distributes it well. You can fall into those aspects of your game, but he never does that. He loves to get downhill, invites the contact, and gets to the cup with a purpose. Earns him a lot of trips to the charity stripe, where he's shooting 68% on the year. As he puts that one home. Thomas now 4-of-6 from the free throw line. Correction, make him 5-of-7 actually. To the paint. Lane outside, three-pointer for Washington, and it's on the money. Every time the Trojans seem about to shave more off the deficit, the Red Hawks come back. Cooper too strong on the tray. Houston sucks in the board. Let's play. lane. Aerial pass for Lillard. No good. Lillard's a sharpshooter. He's 7 out of 11 on the evening, but no good there. Now Thomas floating, swatted by Lillard. It's batted ahead of the pack, and Washington has got all kinds of space. He thought about a jam as the entire IUNW sideline rose to their feet. But the veteran senior just lays it up and in. Now he slaps the floor. He wants all the smoke defensively. Cooper trying to give it to him. Had it poked free. Cooper lost his dribble. Gets the pass up and over, but Thomas has to retreat off the Houston tip. Just 6 on the shot clock. Lambert has to make something happen. He has it poked free. Great defensive stand for the Red Hawks. And a transition foul by Keontae Thomas. A frenzied sequence, but the Trojans could not find a way to get a quality look. The Red Hawks galvanizing on defense and finding a way to prevent the Trojans from generating anything promising on that possession. We've nearly reached the midpoint of the final period. Just over 10 minutes remaining in this contest. Red Hawks were put under some pressure, but they have managed to parry the Trojan attack as there's a three drained by Keone Lane. So once again, a 20-point advantage for the Red Hawks after Trinity had nearly cut it to single digits. Now Lambert blocked from behind, almost got it back. Cahoon does, he flips it up off the rim, and Kone with the great pursuit to get his second bucket of the evening. Kone, a perfect 2 out of 2 from the field. Tyler Houston, who's gotten extended minutes with his point guard counterpart, Malik Miller, in foul trouble all evening long. Houston to the inside. Johnson tried the quick hitter, but it was well read by the Trinity defense. 11 on the shot clock as the Red Hawks will still have it. Wide open is Washington. Pump fake, now a tray, and he knew that was money from the moment it left his hand. Washington starting to combust here in the second half. He's got himself 8 points off the bench. Presniakovas, nice layup there, using his length and great body control. Shades of Dr. J as he reaches from the wrong side of the backboard and scoops that one through. Stand back, bull rushing to the cup. 3-pointer, no good. Washington had the heat check there. The Red Hawk bench was ready to explode if that went down. Now here's Lambert, takes the bump and finds a way to finish, and Lambert's saying, where's my call? That should be a 3-point play opportunity for Monte. Now he's starting to turn it on offensively, his first field goal, and he's got 4. Now Reed, good ball movement. Washington again, and he's got this one. 11 for Davion Washington, and a pair of threes in recent moments. Cooper gets hacked. So the 20-point advantage remains for the Red Hawks. This score here shows just how low-scoring the Trojans' defeat to Roosevelt was the last time out, as this was the final score, 73-53 in favor of the visitors. But there's still 8 minutes remaining in this one, and it's a good thing there are, as Presniakovas puts this one up, and they've credited him with the and one. Wasn't sure if they'd given it to him, but he does finish through the contact in a big bucket for Presniakovas. The free throw is good, and the burly senior Presniakovas is a great man to turn to when you're in need of a quick bucket, and I think that was a big one for the Trojans there. Open jumper for Lane as he worked his way free, but it's no good. 2-on-1 for Trinity, maybe a 3-on-1 if they hustle. Lambert takes it himself, but he's too strong from a sharp angle. Stand back's got the board. Thought about threading it through, but now they work it to the cup, and Javion Reed gets the finish through the contact. So the Trojans struggling to build consistent momentum whenever they strike back. The Red Hawks manage to turn it on in their own right and counter the Trojan strike. So we saw the three-point play for Presnikovas. Javion Reed has got a chance to notch one of his own. Just 4 points off the bench for Reed, but he's 2 out of 2 from the field. An efficient effort as this one rims out. Presnikovas toward the inside, bulldozing his way in there, but he has it knocked loose. Oh, a nice move to the cup, and he almost got that to go. A wild fling after a great move by Johnson, but he couldn't finish it. Now cross, wide open, triple, no good. Colby Cross had an open look at a transition, and that would have been a big-time three-pointer for the Trojans. They need a lifeline here. Left short by Lillard, but he gets his own and finishes it off. And now we get a stoppage, a Trojan timeout. And after TIU reduced the deficit to just 11, it has swollen back up to a 77-56 IUNW Red Hawk lead. Well, the Trinity Trojans have made some great adjustments here in the second half. They've been playing better defense, but still, the body of work is terrific for the Red Hawks. They've splashed home 9 triples. They're shooting better than 52% from the field. And the Trojans, offensively, they've been just okay so far. And just okay is not what these Trojans are looking for. They are a great offensive team. And they want to showcase that. They want to get out and run. They want to shoot a high percentage. They want to generate a lot of shots. But the problem right now tonight is they're being outshot by 6 shots. They're being outmade from the floor by 10 buckets. They just haven't been able to keep pace with the Red Hawks. They're going to have to clamp down defensively like they were doing out of the gates in the second half and play their best offensive ball of the night, play the way we've seen all season. And it's a tall task, but they could manage to watch this deficit evaporate. It's going to take a strong effort from the Trojans, however. Here's Thomas. Almost had it knocked loose. Cahoon rides, fire, 3, no good. Rebound tipped by Standback into the waiting hands of Lamarius Lillard. Tyler Houston will take his time with it. Mishandled but recovered by Johnson. Good hands by Cross to prevent the quick draw triple by Houston. Now Houston putting moves on Cross. It's tipped, but it leads Lillard to the bucket. He's got the lay-in, and he blasts through the 20-point threshold. He's got 21 to lead the Red Hawks. Presnikovas looking for options. He's got the man, Keontae Thomas. The Trojan star Thomas chucks it off the foot of Houston. A kick save and a beauty from Tyler Houston. Looking like Emmy Martinez in the final minute of the World Cup. Problem is, this is the wrong sport, so it stays with Trinity. Thomas tried to have a little dipsy-do and reverse it in, but he came up a bit short. Now Houston working against Braden Betzner, getting some extended time, is the Trojan freshman. Blast pass by Houston, high off glass, and it is money. And the Red Hawks will not slow down this evening. They've gashed it open to a 25-point lead. Floating through the sky was Thomas, and he'll head to the stripe. Boy, Thomas just sauntering to the rack for what would have been an outstanding finish as he cupped it next to his ear and floated through the clouds, looking like A little bit like Yoshi and Super Mario Brothers, where, you know, he makes that jump and you think he's going to come down, right? And he just kicks those feet and keeps propelling upward. That's the type of athletic ability that Thomas has as he just slides his way to the rim. First free throw is no good for Thomas. He is 5 of 8 from the charity stripe today. Second one on the money. Trinity in need of a feverish run as we close in on 5 minutes to play. Here's Houston, pestered by Thomas. Intercept by Presniakovas, but he has it knocked free in turn by Houston. Houston's had a nice night running the offense. And now to the inside and stand back, but he couldn't get it to go. Thomas in transition, flips it over to Presniakovas, extends but cannot finish. Rebound by Lillard and a timeout to retain possession by the Redhawks, I believe. Nope, they will call a foul against Lawani, I think it was. One of those two, very similar numbers, 24 and 23. Couldn't tell exactly which man it was called upon. But nonetheless, possession staying with the Redhawks via the infraction. Houston slips by his man, flips it over to Standback, who got a couple bodies in the air and puts it through. Aaron Sufer just in for the Trojans, one of their captains, a veteran presence, really smart player and a great leader for this Trojan team. Good to see him getting some action here. Lawani just off the mark, and Thomas could not haul it in as it spins beyond the boundary. Well, Houston will check out after a strong sequence. Malik Miller with a smile on his face as he is finally cleared to return. Miller dealing with 4 personal fouls, and that kept him sidelined for most of the second half. He was strong while he was in the game. 6 points on 3 out of 4 from the field and 4 dimes for Miller. But he is on the precipice of hitting the showers a little early, so they were careful with him. Miller to La Follette. La Follette is double, now tripled as they force the pass. Standback was looking for a highlight, but he was a bit careless with it. Now Bloom on the inside, out to Betzner, wide open 3. It's through. And Braden Betzner making a positive highlight out of what's been a difficult evening for TIU, as the freshman sniper does his thing with a long-range bucket. Miller almost shuffled the feet, but gets it out to La Follette, who fires away looking for the answer, but it's no good. Thomas looking to turn and go. Suspended in the air, but he missed the difficult mid-range J. 3 minutes to go, and the intensity is switched down a notch here in Van Dixhorn, with this one likely out of reach for the TIU Trojans. The Redhawks showing what they can do tonight. A high-octane contest and an impressive effort from the visitors. Here's a 3 from Jimmy Washington. It's no good. Both teams deep in their bag with the substitutes here. Sufer out to Thomas. Thomas looked like he was free to fire, but instead he drew the defense and doles out the dime to Bloom. Instead, a traveling violation, and that's pretty much the type of evening it's been for the Trojans. Great play by Thomas as he suctioned the defense toward himself, but Bloom tabbed for the violation. And just a tough evening for Trojan basketball. 2.5 minutes remaining, and we'll see if the squad can close it out on a positive note. 3-point effort from Nikki Flesher is no good. Rolls out toward Miller. As the Redhawks reset, Miller steps into a deep triple. It's off the front rim, And Bloom scrambles for the board. Sufer slings it over to Cross. To the corner and Christian Cranbull. It's five players and five subs for TIU at the moment. Valuable minutes of action for this unit. Cranbull nearly had the bucket, but a little too strong on the inside from the West Chicago, Illinois native. And there goes Blake Creech getting the bucket off the bench for IUNW. You know, these are moments that mean a lot to the players out there. Cross steps into a three, no good, rebound by Lane. But the whole team gets hyped up when one of the substitutes who isn't a rotation player gets in and gets himself a bucket. Always fun moments out here as Flesher crashes to the rim but couldn't get that rebound to go. Now Cranbull will have another effort. Gets blocked, but he gets his own. Out to Cross. Colby Cross on the money. And Cranbull picking up the rebound and the assist to dime up his teammate, Colby Cross. We're under a minute to play, and what's been a tough night. Timeout to get substitutes out there. Trey Steinhilbert back in the third string point guard to run the offense for the final 52 seconds. But the Trojans' last couple games, their offense has just, it's been solid. It's just not been where they want it. And they'll need to continue to shore up the defense, which has been a persistent issue as this season has worn on. This team has potential to be great, but they're being restricted a little bit by some of those shortcomings on the defensive end as Creech provides a highlight there, takes the alley-oop, and sends the IUNW sideline into jubilation. A terrific alley-oop slam to Blake Creech. As this one is just about in the record books. Cranbull looking to get himself a bucket. He rises up, but he has it stuffed. Blake Creech is going off in the waning moments of this one. Perhaps showing the IUNW coaching staff something here late. But that is going to do it. Steinhilber will sit on it and run out the clock. The final seconds has migrated off the timepiece, and we're done here. A fun evening of Trojan basketball, but it does not yield the results that this team was looking for. Lamarius Lillard leading the Red Hawks with 21 points in a 22-point win over the TIU Trojans. They come up a little bit short. The Trojan women, in a perseverant effort, they come up short as well. Good fight from TIU. They drop to 13-11 on the season. Well, that is going to do it for tonight at Van Dixhorn. My name is Ethan Oskroba. Thanks for spending your Wednesday night here with us. And have a great rest of your evening. Trojans suffer defeat at the hands of the IUNW Redhawks.